you have the treasure. Each and every command along with its, you know, entire working example, it's shown over here, right? So what I'm going to do now is let me just see that what are the processes running. I mean, what were the processes that were running in this memory when the dump was made? So using PS list. Okay, by the way, is it okay for you, right? I mean, you are understanding, or am I going too fast or something? Just do let me know. Right. So here I have, what I have done is volatility hyphen F bin, the profile that I have got using image info. See, so the image info showed me this is the profile. Correct. Using that, I gave the profile and I just told that show me the PS list. So it gave me all the processes list. And here you can see there are a lot of processes. Okay. Before I go into that, one question for you all. Did I mention about PID and PPID in the previous class, that how you can determine the PID and PPID? Let me know, please. Did I mention about PID and PPID examples? Anyone? I think so. I did mention about PID and PPID with the same example of svc host.exe, right? But still, do let me know if I have not. I think I have already in the first class itself. Okay, I'll just repeat it once more. See, this PID and PPID are very important in terms of analyzing the processes, right? Let's take an example of this svc host, svc host.exe, okay? And there is services.exe, right? Which has a PID of 680, right? So this services.exe, okay, I'll just, you know, minimize this. Now it's clear, right? So this services.exe have a PID of 680 over here, correct? And this svc host has 680 as PPID, right? So what can you conclude is svc host has PPID 680, which is matching for services 680. Means svc host is a sub process of services. Means it's a legit process which is running, because svc host should be under services only. So if you find that any of the process, for example, svc host, the PPID is not matching with the PID of the legit process, then it's something suspicious. It's a red flag. Is it easy? Did you all understand it? Do reply. Okay, cool. So here I can determine that services.exe has 680 as PID, and the PPID of svc host is matching, means legit. And there are multiple svc hosts running in Windows system. If you ever observe the task manager, right? 680, 680, 680, 680, 680. So this alg.exe also is a process of services.exe, but I've never heard about alg, right? There is something mss something dot exe, which has 584 and 284. So no one has 584 and 284. It's an individual process running. It has ctfmon. A ctfmon is a legitimate process, but okay, that's also cool. Ctfmon, it has a legitimate process. Then we have this msimn.exe, and we have this cmd.exe. So cmd was executed. Now how come the cmd is running by default? Then we have wc.exe, mdd.exe, right? There is something, there are some things that we need to analyze now over here, right? Now similarly, we can do ps tree to get a detailed view. Now I'll use ps tree. See, I got PS3, and here I have the dot 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 indicating the child and the subchild processes. Correct? So here is explorer.exe, which is 284 and 244. So this is 244. MDD.exe. So explorer.exe is running under MDD.exe. Can you see this? Explorer has PPID of 284 and MDD.exe has a PID of 284. Now, do let me know, is it something common? Is it something general? Or is it a red flag indication? Now, how to do that? We need to analyze this MDD.exe, right? Now, today we are going to do something nice. What we are going to do is, see, there is PS scan also available as a command. Okay, does the same thing. And what we are going to do now is, we are going to do proc dump. Okay. So dumping these processes, right? So they are in proc dump slash d, the directory and the process, the 296, right? So we can dump all the processes or we can, you know, dump a specific process. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a directory over here, mkdir dump. You can see there is dump folder now, and I'll use volatility hyphen the same command here instead of ps3. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do proc dump hyphen d, that where I want to dump that file, I want to dump it in the dump folder, and hyphen p is for the process. Okay, so which process I want to dump? I want to dump this mdd.exe, which is 244. Okay, so I'll dump 244, enter. Now see what volatility will do now. See, now once we go into that folder, we have that executable 244. We have that mdd.exe extracted from the memory image. We just extracted a dump from the memory image. How useful it is, see, volatility. Now I'll go into virus total. Let me drop this mdd.exe over here. What can you conclude? That it is safe. It's, in short, it's a legitimate process. And this is a false positive. You can just say that. Correct? Now, let us try to analyze the image even more. We had a few more things over here. We had ALG, we had WC, and we also had MSIN. So let me try to dump this WC, because it is, you can say 364 is matching nowhere over here. We have this SMSS.exe also, which is also kind of, okay, so no, SMSS is a process of system. So it's okay. Let me just try to dump this WC. So the WC is 364. The same command. I want to dump the process 364. Enter. It will dump WC.exe from the memory image. I have this executable 364. Again, go into virus total. Zoom. Kaboom, see over here. So this process over here that is going on, known as wc.exe, something unusual. What it is? Malware. So out of 7364, flagged as in malware. Now details, if I go into the DLL file which it is affecting. Right, relations. Okay. Oops, sorry. The behavior which DLL files it is affecting. See, this malware is executing these DLL files. These many registry entries are being opened. These many registries have been deleted. PC health reporting. So it is, you know, allowing, disabling the PC health, and so many registries have been created. Right. Now this is the full generic report. Let me just go and search of this. Oops, sorry. Okay, so this analysis has been expired. No worries. It is a password dumper, basically. Right? Is it understood what I've done till now?
Yes, sir. May I ask a couple of queries?
Yeah, sure.
My first query is, how can we get the RAM dump? Second, can we trust VirusTotal, as a whole, is it foolproof that the result showing VirusTotal is legitimate? Because I have seen there are certain malwares which we can use and which are not filtered by VirusTotal. So how legitimate is to use VirusTotal in this scenario?
Right. Now, see, number one, how to get the RAM dump. You remember in the first class I had told about the magnet RAM capture tool, right? You can dump memory image using magnet RAM capture. It's a free tool, open source tool. Okay. There are a lot of couple of tools also, but it is one of the most easy GUI tool available out there. Okay. Answer to the second question, sir, over here, number one is, I'm just giving an example. In practical perspective, a detailed analysis is done. Right? So there could be a special Marvel analysis team also doing analysis on this thing. Right? Third thing,
means this is VirusTotal kind of beginning.
I'm just showing an examples. Right? You know? And third thing, VirusTotal in general, you are absolutely correct. In fact, I can show you and create such exe file which is undetected by VirusTotal also, right? Because of the signature and change and all. But you know, there is a funny fact. What does VirusTotal do? You know, I'll tell you a secret. What does VirusTotal do is, for example, you upload an exe file or whatever on VirusTotal, even exe file or a hash or a URL, okay? Initially, for at the first time, it will show you undetectable, okay? I know the people get, you know, happy. Oh, we have made a FUD, or we have made an UD. Fully undetectable or undetectable, right? Now what happens is, VirusTotal, this clever chap, you know, this website, it shares the result with antivirus companies.
Okay.
Eventually, after a few days, you analyze the same exe file, there will be a lot more antivirus detecting it already now. Because this VirusTotal, it has already distributed the results to antivirus companies. Right? So, what's the conclusion? VirusTotal is the biggest enemy for threat actors, for offenders, and VirusTotal is the biggest friend for defenders.
Right.
Right? Because I won't say that it is 100% reliable. But yeah, I mean, you see in the industry standard, many a times VirusTotal is used.
Okay. And also one more, do we need to manually analyze every time which PID and PBID are matching, or there is some sort of another technique in the scenario? Means if the result is a very huge, if there are number of PIDs available, then we need to analyze one by one. Or we can do some more tricks over there.
We can do certain tricks, and we can do not exact full-fledged filtering, but we can do partial filtering, right? And don't worry on that. Filtering, I will cover, you know, in tomorrow's class for volatility. We're done. Okay. Now going ahead, let us, you know, you can see, let us, what we'll do is, let us choose a different sample. So I'll just choose sample 004 example dot bin image info. I mean, these are very old samples. Okay. So it will be some XP or 7 only. Execute multiple volatility tabs, and for each one, for example, we can even dump files. Okay, we can even dump registry, we can even dump processes, EVT logs, binary event logs, right? So what I could do is I could just go back over here, import it EVT logs. Here I can change the name of the txt file to event logs.txt, and instead of, you know, waiting for the output on the screen, automatically the output will be fetched in the txt file. Okay, specify dump directory. This is something which is dumping, so I don't guess txt will work. So that's taking some time. Nothing is written, so the command is taking some time, nothing else. We can even specifically, if you see, dump the memory associated with an individual file. Right? So it's done. Can you see this? So what I'll do is I'll just quickly copy this link, go into our Teams and give it over here itself right now. So this is, okay, and this is, you can say volatility command reference, and here I'm pasting the link. You can just refer to it, and the cheat sheet also, the link is over here, official volatility website, it's there for the cheat sheet. And cheat sheet, done. So, any doubts so far? No doubts. Okay. That's cool. Okay. So now actually I have another meeting scheduled in next 2 minutes. So if it's okay for everyone, can we conclude the class over here? Tomorrow we will just see a few more volatility use case for you can say filtering, and we will move on to another concept for RAM analysis.
Sure, sir.
Right.
Sure.
Okay. So that's all for then today's class. Make sure you try volatility, and the best way I'll tell you to try volatility is to try, you know, create a dump of your own system so that dumping practice is also done. And then use volatility on it. Right? So that thing you can, you know, easily do.
One more thing, sir. I have a few queries regarding some practical kind of case scenario. At what time would be convenient for you so that we can discuss over the call?
Tomorrow afternoon, sir, would be great.
Afternoon, around 2:30.
Yeah, no worries.
All right then.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Yes. So we'll wind up the class over here, and we'll meet tomorrow, the same time with some more volatility use cases, and then move on to other exercises of RAM analysis.